So this is a fun one. We are going to talk about seven tricks and tips to get you moving through grading and giving feedback even faster and more efficient. So first up, this is my grade book. I'm in SpeedGrader right now. And one of the first things is using some shortcuts in here. If you were to click on the gear up here, you're going to be able to see what these keyboard shortcuts are. This means when I am anytime in SpeedGrader and I hit J, I will then go to the next student in the grade book instead of me scrolling over and hitting the right arrow. If I want to go to the previous student, I can hit K and it'll go backwards instead of scrolling and doing that. C will automatically move my cursor to the comment box. R will open a rubric instead of me needing to click it. So super easy in there. So let me just show you how that works. If I'm in here right now, this is just a formative assessment. I can hit J and I can just be cruising through my different students here. If I want to leave a comment on something they wrote, I can just hit C and it jumps me over to that box. Super easy, tip number one. Tip number two is also very, very amazing that's in here. And dare I even say life-changing. Number two is this. If you click on the gear once again and go to options, you have the ability for submissions to sort instead of by the default in alphabetical mode. You can then submit their assignments basically by their submission status. So basically what happens is, let's say I've gone through, I've graded it all at one point, but then I have all these stragglers that come in, but I'm trying to figure out where those are. If I sort it by submission status, it'll put those that need to be graded right at the top and doesn't require me to scroll and find that little dot that says, hey, you didn't grade this yet, and there's no green check mark next to it. So I love this. And you can save this setting, and it will be true for all of your assignments in the future. And that will, if there were assignments to grade, put them right at the top with their little circles. So super cool, grade sorting under options while you're in there. Now you can also in here, if you wanted to, hide the student names that are in here. This will allow them to then be just anonymous students while you're grading if you want to be more unbiased perhaps as you're looking at them. Tip number three. Also very, very cool as we are looking at different tips is the filters in your gradebook. So let's say you're in here. If you have not turned on filters, you want to go to view and turn on as many filters as you have here. I find this super helpful as you're grading things because now I could go and just look at formative practice. I could look at formatives within unit 8, or maybe I was looking at unit 9 of who did certain things. Not a lot at the end, but you can do this as you're going through, and maybe I want unit 5 and just to look at their tests for that unit. Makes it super easy to find things and then go into the grade book. So highly, highly recommend filters in here, and goodness gracious, make sure that you have not clicked unpublished assignments. Make sure that is not clicked. You don't need random things in your grade book that are not published, not accessible, and you're never getting grades for them. So make sure this is not clicked, but rather unclicked in here. Number four, this is super cool, but this is looking at group assignments. So here's just something that I did for AP review, and I assigned this to groups. Now you can create groups in your course. Under the people tab, there's directions below in this kind of activity here. But what you do is basically when they submit, this is the coolest part of this. If you assign the assignment to a group, it means when they submit, my settings are still on from before, so I'm gonna unhide that. But you're gonna see that it's just the team names instead of this. So when the team submitted, I was then able to give them points based on what they did for the entire team, then anyone on this team in the grade book gets the same grade. This was just a formative review activity, but something really cool when you're handing in and you're like, which group didn't submit? It'll tell you very clearly. You then make those groups under the people tab. You create a group set, and here are my five groups that I had, and you can manually add people to these teams to make the teams. And then when you're in an assignment, all you need to do, if I go back to this assignment, is say that it is a group assignment. And then it will only be looking for, so anyone on the team can then Submit this right now. It's not graded, but if it were graded, we'll change that back. You'll see down below here, this is a group assignment. And then I assigned it to those sets that I made, and basically any one person on that team can submit. And then I can see that and see which teams did not submit. Super easy. You can also assign grades to kids individually and still have one submission if you know maybe who did what part of the project. Super time savings. Love this. Again, ask for more support if you need it while using the group assignment tool. And dare I say, last but not least, we have two more tips here. Number six is using the Canvas mobile app. I think for some assessments, it is easier to grade in the app versus grading in the speed grader on your computer. So double check, download it to iOS or Android. You can see if it's easier for you, but I have found super easy on some assessments to grade on a rubric and then just swipe over and go to the next kid. So if you're good at that, might be helpful for you to grade in that way. And last but not least, this one probably the most amazing in my opinion, although I think all of these are fantastic. But something that I do in my course is this. I am able to use Hapara along with Canvas together, do a little app smashing here, but here is what is great. The way that I have them and I set up my assignment, I have it in a way where in here, I have the revision history. So Anna here resubmitted this. So I see that I have two submissions here, an original and a regraded option. What's nice about how this looks in here, because it looks different, it's not just a PDF, I can see her revision history. And so for any writing-based assessment, where I just want to see what did she even change, I can see that after I commented, there was one time she went in here. I can just scroll on down and see anything she changed. She changed a word there, little typo, added this. This is the only thing I need to regrade. Compared to if it was a PDF going back and forth, being like, what did I just had to read the whole thing over again. But not with this. So this is in the last module of this course. If you're curious to learn how to do this, it is so life-changing if you're doing any grading or revising grades from written work. Amazing. So hopefully those seven tips helped you in some way. We're always here to help you, and I hope that you found something that was useful to you.